this is Terri. Welcome back to my channel. Today's topic is about me feeling incredibly wounded, raw emotionally. I'm in a better place now than I was earlier this morning, but this was all kind of triggered by some stuff that's going on with our son Adam in San Diego State, which I'll talk about in just a minute, and also this cutie patootie little picture. So I have this picture out in a little, what would you call it? The little set, it's got the tree, and then what would you call it? The little setting on the coffee table?
Yeah, them? It's a little tray. Isn't it?
It's a little tray. I've got a couple of things on there. And last night we were watching Ocean's 8. It was you liked it.
It's a fun movie.
It's a fun movie. Anyway, so we were watching Ocean's 8, and I was looking, and our cat Zuko ended up laying down right next to this. It was just like this cute little scene. And I looked at this picture of this sweet, and hopefully I'm not going to cry, I'm going to cry. This sweet child, this innocent child, and how did he end up in this situation that he is, that's basically destroying him down in San Diego because of a series of super unfortunate events. And this is, I don't know where I'm at hormonally, if this is kind of what's going on, if it's the season. I'm feeling, I'm dealing with a whole bunch of different things right now. Doesn't mean that I'm not going to be okay. So if you're worried about me, I'm fine. But there's just a lot going on. And so in seeing this picture and then thinking about what he's going through, it just got me thinking about just how hard it is to be a parent when, especially when you're an empath, like, I am, where you feel things so intensely and deeply. And you want the best for your children, and you know when you see that they are really suffering and in pain, whether they know the extent of it or not, just how hard it is to deal with this. I remember, and maybe part of it is I'm having some flashbacks to when my brother, who was, we say that he was dropping acid on a daily basis when he was 16 after me and my twin sister went off to college. I was talking to someone about that. It was like, yeah, that's probably not what was happening. So, but whatever. He was running away. He was not going to school. He was not doing good things. And so my parents sent him away to Wilderness Conquest. It saved his life. It was one of the most traumatic things, the family reuniting type situation in Utah. I hate the state of Utah for this whole reason. It was really, really hard. I was, I had moved back my sophomore year of college, and so I was living at home for a couple months before I got an apartment, and I was going to Cal State Hayward at the time. I think I was also working for my parents at the time. So my sister was off at Chico, so she wasn't really directly involved with this, but you know, we had BJ, kidnapped from school, driven to Utah. He went to this program and...
Kidnapped?
We basically had him abducted. I guess you can't kidnap your own kid, you know, basically...
I'm sorry, what? Abducted?
We basically had some people from the program go and pick him up from school, get him in a car, and then drive him up to make sure that he safely got up to the program.
That's
whack. So fast forward, he admits that it saved his life, but when he was 19, 20, 21, somewhere in there, he just kind of disappeared. And I remember watching my mom worry so much about my brother, and I was worried about him too, because we didn't know, was he alive, was he not alive? I know more, at least once, if not twice, we went up to San Francisco where he was supposedly living. We didn't know where, we didn't know how, we didn't know how he was making money. And we would show his picture around to make sure that people had seen him to know that he was still alive. And I remember my mother lived on Coca-Cola and peanut M&Ms for a couple of years as she worried about BJ. And I remember all of this, and I remember, I mean, I didn't feel the same way, and it wasn't until I had my own children that I understood that level of worry and that level of care that you have for your children. You know, this is the worry. And I know worry is the interest that you'd pay on a debt that you may never owe. I understand that. But it's, you know, really trying to tell your head to not worry about something that is physically hurting in your heart is really hard to do. I started working with a therapist I mentioned a couple weeks ago. I need to set up my second appointment. I'm still...
You haven't had your second appointment yet.
No, I mean, with Thanksgiving and everything, it's been a little bit tricky. But the one thing that we were specifically working on had to do with holding on to what is mine to carry and to worry about versus letting go of something that is not mine to carry and worry about. And I still feel like I'm working on that. So
yeah, it's only been one session.
It has, but at the same time, it's something that I'm kind of working on and practicing, and I want to have mastered it a little bit before I have another conversation to continue to work on it. This is the way that I operate in coaching.
Dude, with therapy, you can't expect to get something in one session. That just doesn't happen.
I understand that, but I don't feel like I've done what we've talked about doing, so I don't feel quite ready to go back. Anyway, setting that aside, so I am trying to make sure that I am focusing on what's mine. At the same time, I feel like San Diego State and San Diego are the gifts that keep on giving in a very negative way. You know, if you've watched previous episodes, you heard about Adam's friend who died last year and sent Adam into a bit of a tailspin. Depression and grief from the loss, depression of his friend Dylan, depression and grief from the loss of his social, and then just not really knowing where he fit in down there. And then, of course, COVID, and then this semester has been bad. And then he got a letter from the university, which we talked about on the episode where I got stoned. And then we just found out 2 days ago that the family has filed suit for a wrongful death claim against the university, the CSU system, the bed manufacturer, because he fell out of the bed in the dorm, the fraternity, and they've named some fraternity brothers. Adam was a pledge, he was not asked, but I was like, God, you know, they just, the 1 year anniversary of Dylan's death was just last month, and that was hard on all of his friends. And by the way, I don't want to discount the feelings for his family. I am devastated for them. The thing is that several of us parents who have talked know that it could have been our kid. It was such an unfortunate accident that happened in such an unfortunate way. It was so incredibly unlucky. And every day I'm grateful that it was not Adam. And every day I think about his family and just how awful this is. At the same time, Adam's life continues to, I feel like, be destroyed from something he was not directly a part of. I mean, he was part of the pledge process. He was, you know, at the event the night before this tragedy. But, you know, the fact that it just keeps coming up and coming up, it's making it very difficult for Adam to be able to move on, and therefore the rest of us to be able to move on. And so it's just, it's hard to see your child continue to suffer and be in pain around something and not really have the tools to just not be equipped to effectively deal with it. I'm trying to work with him on some stuff to kind of coach him through it, because it's really up to him to decide, you know, what help he wants and how he wants to move forward. He did withdraw from San Diego State for the spring semester, so we are moving forward on that, and we've responded to the letter that he got before Thanksgiving, asking some more questions. We have not received responses back, and then we will deal with that. And the next step is to work with the admissions offices at the two schools he's identified, LMU and Chapman, to see if we can get him into there for spring semester or fall semester. So there's a path forward, and that's what keeps me grounded, is knowing that we are working together to take steps forward in a positive direction. But when these things kind of come at, it's overwhelming. And the reason why I wanted to talk about this is there are a lot of people who think I have my shit together, who always moves boldly through the world, always has a plan, and this is just me saying, I don't. Sometimes, but I am willing to take steps, I'm willing to do things despite all of this crap going on, thus the hashtag one brave thing. Constantly trying to focus on energy management and spending energy on those things that I can affect change or moving forward and being positive. Oh, and that's another thing is, I am an eternal optimist. You know, being an Aries and being born in the spring, I'm always about rebirth and new, and there's got to be a pony in that pile of shit. And I keep looking for that fucking pony. Like, what good is supposed to come from this? What are all of us supposed to learn from this entire situation? And each time something comes up, I'm like, I guess we haven't learned it, and we are going to continue to try to learn it.
You look for the silver lining, even if it's just you with a roll of aluminum foil.
Yeah, aluminum foil is shiny. I mean, look, yeah. And I have shiny earrings on.
So it's like close enough to a real silver lining. You just like wrap something with aluminum foil.
Are you discounting that and saying that I'm manufacturing something that isn't real, or
no?
Oh, okay.
I'm saying you're gonna find the silver lining even if you have to make it yourself.
Yeah, I can cut that shit up and turn it into glitter. I can make myself a tiara. So I have to. It's the way that I operate, and that's the way that I look at the world. So yes, I will have moments that are bad. And this morning, you know, there was a situation with a friend yesterday that really wounded me. I won't go into details, but it just made for me being incredibly sensitive and raw this morning, knowing that every interaction I was going to have today, I need to be very careful about, whether it's online, via text, email, or even verbal interactions. I need to make sure that I'm very careful in what it is that I say, how I say it, and making sure I only take on what I can handle today. So today is like a kid glove kind of day. On a positive note, I just had a really fabulous conversation with one of my portfolio company founders, Noah with Via Global Health. I talk about it, I love them all, but I really love what they're doing in this world. And I am always uplifted and feel inspired when I talk to him, like I do with several of my portfolio company founders. And that helped. That was a bit of a salve on an open wound of a day. Also had a call with a vendor for a client project, and I was really afraid that it was going to be very difficult. And the guy said, oh yeah, we'll be flexible. And I even said to him, I said, I'm about to cry with relief because I was really afraid that this was going to go sideways. And I already had the backup plan to the backup plan, but I'm like, thank you for not adding one more thing. So so fortunately, there have been some good things that have made today easier. But we in the Mead family are in a bit of a rough place. I wouldn't say that we're necessarily in crisis. It's just a matter of we just have a lot on our plates right now. And as usual, lots of moving pieces and trying to enjoy the holiday. Speaking of which, we need to map out our cookie baking.
Crinkles are top of the list.
Oh, are we going to do peppermint crinkles?
No, just chocolate crinkles.
Oh, okay.
Tradition, mother. That is one of the That is one of the traditions we must always uphold.
Okay.
Chocolate fucking crinkles.
Yes. So, well, maybe we'll do a quick little episode on the different cookies that we make, because this is something that we've been doing for years, is baking cookies. So I have that to look forward to. So we will be mapping that out. And we watched Ocean's 8 last night. Do we get to watch a Christmas movie tonight? Oh, come on. Okay, I'm playing Christmas carols.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
What else did I want to? Okay, once again, I just want to say this is not a cry for help. If you do want to respond and to say, hey, how are you doing? I actually want to know how all of you are doing. I was talking to Noah, and I was like, I think we will see a glimmer of sunshine come September. Between the change in leadership within the United States with the vaccine and, you know, maybe getting some things under control. So I'm mentally kind of expecting that the next couple months are going to continue to be hard, and then we'll see things kind of lighten up. And then by September, maybe things will be, we'll see glimmers of what the new normal is going to look like. So
it's going to be whack when we can go around in public without masks. Again.
Yeah, but you know, California's shutting down right now, and I am so fucking pissed because we have been so good, and there are others in the state and this country who have not. And fuck you to all of you who are, well, actually, you're not even watching. Never mind. I'm not even gonna go there. I'm not giving that energy today because it's just pointless. So
stop shuffling the papers.
Well, Okay, I just want to make sure that I'm covering everything. So
you had all of the papers laid out in front of you. You could have looked to your right.
Well, I'm just making sure. Anyway, so please be kind to yourself. Please be kind to others. Know that everybody is really struggling right now, even though they may not necessarily show it. Some of us put on a brave face moving forward, and in order to be strong for those of us around, for those who are around us, and for those who might need it more than we do. I will figure this out. We will figure this out. We will be fine. It's just hard right now. And so giving you some extra love as we move through whatever it is that we are moving through and that you are moving through. And with that, I just want to say thank you so much for watching. Please, forgot to say, for the stupid SEO thing, please like this video, add a comment, or respond to the question that I ask in there, which will be, how are you? And I'm asking it legitimately, how are you?
And if you have any pets, how are your pets?
I care. Ray cares about your pets. I care more about you.
No, I think it's just an easier question to answer.
Okay. As usual, like the crazy hair, crazy day, this might be the signal that you just, it's a wild ride of a conversation. And, thank you so much for subscribing. We're up to 215 subscribers. Woohoo! I guess it'd be woohoo! If you know somebody who might appreciate this, please pass it along and ask them to subscribe too. And with that, let go of perfection, take some risks.